giving glory to the Lord. He reigns. Lord reigns in the affairs of men. Amen. Glory to him forever in the mighty name of Jesus. May his name be blessed and be praised in all eternity. Amen. Reading from Matthew chapter 17, verse 19. Then came the disciples to Jesus apart. Matthew 17, verse 19. And said, why could we not cast him out? There was a case just prior to that time. A man brought his son who was sick of lunatic, a mental issue. And they couldn't cast it out. Having brought him to the disciples, they helped in their little way, but their help was not just sufficient. And the demon wouldn't go. And they brought the young man to Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ immediately cast the devil out. And the man was made whole and was saved from his problem. And the disciple came to Jesus afterward and asked him, verse 19, why could not we cast out that demon from that boy and make him whole? And Jesus answered unto them and said, because of your unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if you have faith as grain of mustard seed, as small as mustard seed, you shall say to this mountain, to this problem, remove from here to yonder place, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. Note that word, nothing shall be impossible unto you. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. Howbeit, verse 21, this kind goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting. That verse 20 takes my attention. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. And in reality, in real life, there are things we have to get here. Otherwise, you'll be making a very big mistake. And we often do that as believers when we read the Bible. We often don't pay attention to some little details that will actually help our faith and make us to get to the level where Jesus is referring to here and say, nothing shall be impossible unto you. The first thing we saw in this place, that the disciples, they came to Jesus Christ and asked questions and say, why couldn't we do exactly as you have done, cast out that spirit from that boy and make him whole? They discovered there was a problem. Then they want an answer to it. They discovered there was something that was scarce. Then they look for a way of making it surplus, making it available. First and foremost, if you don't realize there is a problem, we won't look for a solution. Nobody look for what is not lost. It's when you have discovered something is missing, something is not where it ought to be, that you begin to look for that thing. God forbid you wake up one morning and you do discover a child is in the house that ought to be, and everybody supposed to be there, and this particular child is not there. Immediately you begin to look for him, or something you put in a particular place and that is not where to be found. Immediately you begin to look for it. What is not lost, or what you have not discovered to have gotten lost, nobody will look for it. So the disciples, they discovered that something was missing and there is need for it to be found, and they came to Jesus Christ and say, Master, why couldn't we do it? And Jesus began to give them the answer that will help them in consequence occasions in their life. So first and foremost, we must realize there is a problem. And when there is a problem, then there is need for solution. Then they put that aside. Then secondly, after asking the question, they waited for the answer. They were not in a hurry to go. They waited for the answer received. And we have to really explain a little. Because this is where our problem is many times. First and foremost, we don't ask questions. We don't seek for answers. And even when we do, we are only always in a hurry. We are not patient enough. Because we always think the way the Bible writes on things are just exact way it happens. No. For example, they came to Jesus Christ here. They asked questions. And as if Jesus Christ gave them the answer immediately. Sometimes it is not like that. Prophecy don't come to pass without a period of waiting, and without a period of asking questions, and without a period of seeking for the answers that we seek. Oh, God has given the prophecy. He has sent the promises out. We have received them. There's a period of waiting, and the period of waiting will not be completed without patience and without we looking for answers to small, small dots, small, small loops, and see how we can cover up. Then we find the answer that has been given to us in promises and in prophecy, as the case may be. And look at the woman in particular, the man in particular that brought the child. He said he brought the child to Jesus Christ and to the disciple first, which means he couldn't get to Jesus Christ immediately. Jesus Christ was never alone. There was a man that at a point may have 500 with him. At a point, we are told he had 3,000 counting only men with him, which the people that he felt. At a point, we said he was 16 years, 5,000 with him, men alone, counting men alone, and he felt them. And a place where you have 5,000 men, you can be sure women are there, children are there, maybe a crowd of 10,000. And in a crowd of 10,000 or more, even a crowd of 5,000, and somebody just wake up one morning and say, I want to see Jesus, it will be difficult for sure. To say, I want to see the pastor in a crowd of 5,000, it will take time. So this man that brought the child as a lunatic may have been coming, and it is becoming more difficult to see Jesus. The best he could do was to see the disciple, and they are doing their best. Eventually, the best was not enough. And eventually, because they couldn't do it, they have to bring into Jesus. And to start with also, Jesus was not easily recognizable among them. Remember, when they had to crucify him, he took an internal person, took somebody inside to betray him so that they might know him among the lords. So even those that are following him might be confusing with disciples. So it may take time to get to him. Sometimes when you read the story in the Bible, it's as if the day the man came to see Jesus, that was the same day he found him. Sometimes it's not like that. And come to the disciples too. when they couldn't solve the problem, and they brought the child to him, they asked questions, why couldn't he have done it? And the Bible answered in verse 19, Jesus said unto them, this is the reason why you couldn't heal the child and help the man that brought the young man for healing. That too, it looked as if they asked the question, immediately they have the answer. Now look at it this way. Jesus Christ is never alone. He will always have a crowd of people around him. And that means even the disciples may not always have access to him. And that's why they have to wait. Everybody leave him alone. And he's alone by himself. And that may not happen until very late in the night. And the event we read here, where the man brought the child that was sick, may possibly have happened during the day, maybe in the morning, maybe in the evening. Maybe it even happened they have been following on him before. And the disciples couldn't help. And eventually they saw Jesus. And Jesus cast the spirit out, maybe in the morning or maybe in the afternoon. And they had to wait till late in the evening when everybody has gone before they see Jesus. That took time, that took patience. And now they ask Jesus, why couldn't we do it? And Jesus answered in verse 20. And between the time they ask and they receive the answer to, there will be time lapse. Possibly, who knows, that day Jesus came back after everybody had gone. He was alone and possibly tired. I want to have a little sleep. And they asked him that question. And they said, okay, don't worry, I will answer you tomorrow morning. And maybe it even took a day or two or some hours before they got the answer they have here. And eventually they got the answer, which simply means between the time we ask our questions, we start looking for answers. They say, seek and you shall find. Between the time we start looking for questions, get our question and start looking for the answer, there may be time. And that time may be full or sometimes crisis, sometimes trouble, sometimes more. The thing may become escalated until God step in. It doesn't always work as if it was asked immediately and they received immediately. Look at that woman with issue of blood. He said he has gone everywhere and now came to Jesus Christ. If I can touch the hem of the garment, that may have taken days, possibly months, because the crowd is always there before the woman got access to Jesus Christ. So there's always a period of waiting. And that period of waiting, if we are not careful, is a period we might also lose the answer we want to receive. And that brings us back to prophecy. Individual, personal, and things that are going around us, we must continually pray. Jesus said, without prayer and fasting, this thing won't come to pass. Look at our national life, especially in Nigeria now, things that are going. We have the prophecy that they let it come to power and God will turn things around for us. But if we don't pray, we will not get the answer we want. And the prayer of waiting is where we are now. And while waiting, the devil wants to escalate things to look as if it cannot happen. If you follow an event in the land very carefully, you know we need to pray. All that is happening now are distractions, are devil's work to make sure we refuse praying. we get tired, we get discouraged, and we put our eyes off the purpose of God for us, and we fail praying again. At the end of the day, election may take place, things will happen, and the promise will never be fulfilled. And we say God is not answering prayer again. No, it's because we got relaxed. We got carried away by the event that is happening, by killings and rioting and protests here and there, and we forgot our primary aim of praying or fasting or trusting God for fulfillment of prophecy. Oh, God has given you prophecy about a particular child that will come, or a job that will come, or a particular promise that God has given you, and you'll be laying claim on it. It might even be your head. If you stop praying, or because things are getting worse, or because things are not getting better, you may miss the promise. Promises and promises don't fulfilled. Questions don't get answered. Without a time lag. And that time lag simply means I have to wait. After asking, after start thinking, I have to seeking answer to the question I have. I have to wait. And while waiting, I keep praying, I keep fasting, I keep trusting God. Then the answer will come. So therefore, when you read your Bible and perceive, they ask and they receive immediately. It's not always like that. Sometimes things happen in between. Time lasts in between. Sometimes, just like a man, if you ask a man, say, what do we eat Saturday night? Oh, I ate rice. But that simple answer he gave you may have taken hours before preparing the rice, before preparing whatever you use to make it, and before things happen, come to table and eat, it takes some time, hours. So therefore, first and foremost, let's ask questions. Why are things like this with me? Why are things like this in our family? Why are things like this in our community? Why is our nation like this? When we ask our question, let's patiently wait for the answer. And while waiting, let's pray, let's fast, let's seek for other answers and handles ourselves. Seek and you shall find. And while doing that, it may take time. And eventually, God will answer if we fail not. On the matter of Nigeria, God will answer if we fail not. If you refuse to be distracted by the killing, by the distractions of protests, by the distractions of not having the answer we want in politicians, if you look at all these things around us, we will never have faith. But we look away from them and we trust God to answer our questions, it will be answered. It may even be your own personal life. And to see the more you pray, the more difficult it could become. The more you trust God, the more years are counting. Just wait for it. The answer will come. Prophecy don't get fulfilled without time lags and without patience. If you wait for it, you will see it. They asked Jesus and they waited. And they gave them the answer of peace that they need to know. May you have answer of peace in Jesus' mighty name. Wait for it. Patiently trust him. And you will have the answer you want. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.